Hello fellow investors and influencers, and welcome to our channel if you're watching our videos for the first time. I am Maura, the lesbian unicorn from CoinInfo News, and I would like to help you better understand a few trends that you've probably heard about in the past months. The crypto industry has experienced a few changes in the past years that enabled the emergence of new methods to support new blockchain projects. Thus, projects undergoing ICO or initial coin offering, STO or security token offering, and IEO or initial exchange offering are gaining more and more exposure in the industry. An initial coin offering or ICO, sometimes known as initial currency offering, is a type of crowdfunding using cryptocurrencies. An ICO can be a source of capital for many startup companies. Any individual or company can fund any project or even become an investor. A project usually makes a pretty WordPress-based website explaining why you should invest in their idea and releases a document, which is usually called a white paper, that contains all the essential details about how the system will work. Then people are asked to invest in the project, usually with Bitcoin or Ethereum, but this might vary from one project to another, and in return the investor receives the coin of the project, which can be either a cryptocurrency or a token. After the end of the ICO, the coin will usually be listed on an exchange, and if the hype around that project is big enough, investors will try to sell it to those who did not manage to invest in the ICO, and then the trading begins. If the project is legit and will have a real working ecosystem behind it, the coin will increase in value over time. However, if the project is made only for short-term games, such as the majority of the ICOs these days are, then you'll observe a dump on the market of their coins and their value will drastically drop. This is why you need to be really cautious about the projects you choose to invest your money into, because just as some people got rich overnight, others lost their entire money. The risk is real. Moving on, similar to an ICO, we have STOs. Here an investor is issued with a cryptocurrency or token representing his investment. However, in the case of STO, a security token represents an investment contract into an underlying investment asset, such as stocks, bonds, funds, and real estate investment trust, or REIT. Therefore, a security token represents the ownership information of the investment product recorded on the blockchain. STOs are also seen as a hybrid approach between ICOs and the more traditional initial public offering IPOs. Many countries have banned STOs, however, they are seen to bring a lower risk because the security laws that the security token have to comply often enforces transparency and accountability. Another advantage is that the security token is backed by a real-world asset, which makes it a lot easier to assess whether or not the token is priced fairly in relation to the underlying asset. And last but not least, we have IEOs. An initial exchange offering, or IEO, is conducted on the platform of a cryptocurrency exchange. Contrary to an ICO, the IEO is basically managed by the cryptocurrency exchange on behalf of the startup that seeks to raise funds it needs to implement this project. Basically, the advantages of an IEO are many. Through this method, the project will benefit from the existing user base of the exchange to obtain contributions. Also, it prevents the gas war between sales participants, assuming the exchange is not decentralized. Aside from ensuring their listing on the particular exchange, there is an extra layer of trust that makes it more difficult to find scams among IEOs, because the exchange will conduct its own research before accepting any project. IEOs are thought to benefit all parties involved in the exchange, investors and project. Exchanges basically earn from listing fees, the influx of new users and their deposits and joint marketing with the team from the IEO. Investors earn from funding a legit project, and they provide an extra layer of trust and reduce risk for the team behind the IEO that will receive the fund they need to successfully implement the project. I hope this helped you better understand what an ICO, STO or IEO are. It is important to take into account that this industry possesses a high amount of risk, and you should always perform your own research before taking the decision to invest. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and press the notification bell. You can also join our Telegram channel and keep up with the latest news about blockchain and cryptocurrencies. Thanks for watching, and see you again in the next video.